Let's very briefly take a look at another example of using a subquery inside of a from clause. After that, we'll then understand why we would do this at all. Why do we care about using subqueries inside of a from? So in this particular example, we're going to see that we do not have to return a set of rows or columns from a subquery inside of a from clause. We can return just one single value as long as the outer select statements, the wheres, and so on are compatible with it. So in this case, we're going to write out a subquery that's going to give us back one single value, just one value. Selecting the max from price means let's take a look at the price column by itself, nothing else. And we want to get just the max value inside of here. So in this case, it would be the 989. That is the result of our subquery. It is one row and one column, which we refer to as a value. That's one single value. We can make use of this as a subquery inside of a from clause, so long as the outer select or any additional wheres, group bys, and so on are working or assuming that we are making use or providing just one single value. So if we now try to do a select and say something like, give me all the product names, well, that's going to break because we don't have any names here. If we try to ask for, say, the weights, again, going to break because we don't have a weight column. The only thing we can ask for here is just everything. Give us everything, which in this case is one single value. So let's try once again writing out just the subquery and then integrating that into a larger query on the outside. So we'll once again do a select max price from products. Yep, we get just one value right here. So now we will integrate that into a larger outer query. We'll say select star from, and we'll put in our subquery, select max price from products. And then let's not forget to apply our alias right here. So as B. All right, so I'm going to run that, and you'll see that we get the exact same result. So again, this is a scenario where we don't really need the outer query. I just mean to give this to you as an example of, hey, we can provide a subquery right here that gives us one single value as long as the outer selects and so on are going to agree with the structure of data. All right, so now that we have seen that a subquery inside of a from clause can give us either a set of rows and columns or just one single value, let's now start to understand why we would do this. Why would we ever make use of a subquery inside of a from clause? That's the real question here. So quick pause, and we'll take a look at that in just a moment.